a lot of what you have in your mind. And I know it's very hard. I know it's very hard to lie to yourself all the time, because I'm basically lying to myself all the time. If I see my bank account, it's a lie, because the number that I have in my mind is real. And I know the hardship. I know how fucking hard it is to sit there and talk about being rich and being whatever, but having zero money on your bank account. I never cared about the reality, because the reality is just one perception of my life. How you see your life is your perception. Everyone sees colors different, but there's one thing that is always true. That's your name. If I ask you what your name is, you don't even think about it, because you know that's a fact. This is your name. The same way you easily say your name when someone asks you, you have to think about your success. And for me, it was as easy to say, I am Miguel. It was as easy to say if someone asked me, are you successful? Yes, I'm fucking successful. There's one very important thing that you need to learn right now. Follow the people that have what you want. Every time you learn something, every time you get information from somewhere or someone, ask yourself the question, is this person having the results that I want or not? If yes, continue to listen. If not, then don't listen. 1% less, and you may be very frustrated if you heard it. 1% less are accountable. They hold themselves accountable. It doesn't matter how much money you make. The 1% less are not defined by the money. They are defined by three major aspects. And if you don't follow these three aspects, if you cannot put a check mark behind these three aspects, you are not a 1%er. It doesn't matter how much money you make. Financial freedom, location freedom, and time freedom. These are the three major things you need to do and work on right now. If I put you, let's say if I put you in a community with positive people, where it's about money, where it's about goals, where it's about having targets in life, where it's about positivity, do you think you can change your life? Do you think your life changes if you are with other people? 100%, right? If you hang around with five people that smoke, you also smoke. If you hang around with five people that take drugs, you take drugs. If you hang around with five people that wake up early, you will wake up early, even if you don't like it, right? I'm someone that sleeps wrong, but with all of them together all the time, they always wake me up, right? No chance, okay?
I didn't believe that I was supposed to be an entrepreneur, because many people were like, oh, they want to have jobs. And I've always wanted to have a job, because my dad was an entrepreneur and I didn't like that life. Up, down, I didn't like it. I wanted steady. But then you do the steady and you don't like it. You feel like you're in a box. When I got over the fact that I'm an entrepreneur, everything changed.
Are you ready for 15 hours on the plane?
15 hours next to you, bro.
15
Hopefully
hours.
I just pass out and I wake up in Brisbane, bro. I feel some of you sometimes, especially when you're new to this game, you are overwhelmed very quickly and it's like, oh, there's so much, but I don't know how to create results. But understand that this game actually is very easy. You just have to learn a little bit, continue to do it, detach yourself from the results, from short-term results to long-term results, and you will see your life change. You guys will have to become irrational in the sense and in the eye of the society. The society will tell you, oh, don't talk about money, don't talk about success, get your job, focus on that, right? You at 18, you are a perfect slave. Who is above 18? Most of us, hopefully, right? So when you turn 18, you were the perfect slave for the society. And it's not me saying that, guys. Every successful person I know talks about that. Everyone, and everyone knows that, that you have to get out of the slave mindset. Now, why is network marketing, now why is what we do so badly viewed? Because it's completely okay that they view it badly, because everything in our world is binary. Everything in our world is left or right. Everything in our world is good or bad. Now, if you take this opportunity and you think that it's a good opportunity and you see yourself already succeeding and you see yourself how it should be, this tool, this vehicle, network marketing can change your life. Network marketing will take you from a place and will take you to another place faster than any other businesses. If I, for example, and I'm a multiple six figure, if I look into my team and I have a lot of very successful leaders, if I look at them and I see how fast they became six figure earner, more than 100,000 a year, where is that possible? Where can people these days with a skill or no skill basically join and make six figures of the year consistently? Where? I've never seen any industry like that. Maybe in social media in general, yes, you can have a social media agency, marketing agency, very high paid influencer, not everyone. Network marketing, and it's a positive thing, everyone can do that. I'm not saying like everyone will do it, but everyone can. And that is the crazy thing. I've never seen someone telling me there's a duplicatable system where you become a six figure earner, most likely after 1 year. That's a very powerful thing. So network marketing basically has no limits.
I just
just want you guys to answer honestly. If you think that the world is different than how people taught us the world will be, okay? Just indicate with one finger if you really think that the world is a little bit different than what your families, the school, the system at the end of the day is teaching you. I will tell you a little story. I started back then when I turned 18. When I turned 18, I, for the first time, got together with my girlfriend. We rented an apartment. And that was the time when I understood I don't know shit about life. I'm like, okay, how do I do this? A contract? How do I pay the rent? Where do I send all the kind of stuff? Insurance. I was like, bro, what kind of insurance do I need? Who do I need to call? And I was calling my mom, like, why don't I have electricity? What do I need to do, right? And I'm not a stupid guy. Like, I'm not the smartest, but I'm not stupid. But I figured out that life is so much more of besides of what they teach us. You will have to self-improve yourself every day. There are so many out of the matrix information, people, persons, mentor, books that will teach you the above average information that you need. Why? Because you have to understand in between the poor and the rich, there's an information gap. The only difference is that poor people and rich people, they have different informations, most likely because they were brought up different or they get different information. Now, the information, the quality of information that you will consume will define your financial life. Imagine today you go shopping and you find out that you cannot afford what you want to buy. Now, a poor person will open automatically the folder where the information about the finance or financial education and financial information is stored, and this folder will tell you, I cannot afford. Now, a rich person will see something that they can't afford, and they will ask themselves the question. They will open the same folder, but this folder contains different information, and in this folder it will say, if I cannot afford something, I will have to ask myself the question, how can I afford it?
So what would you do right now if you would go broke completely and you would have start over, you would have to start over again?
Do I have Instagram?
Right now.
Right now? Bruh.
What are you saying, right?
First of all, I think I spend enough money, I go broke every single month, I gotta re-earn it anyways, but that's besides the point. But what I would do, I would honestly find a niche. Like, find something you're interested in, find something you would do for free, and then find out how to make money from that.
You can start to go to the gym, which I really recommend. You really should go to the gym as a networker, especially as a man, but also as a woman. It doesn't really matter because it pushes you. A healthy body, healthy mind. You cannot develop a healthy mindset if you don't have a healthy lifestyle in terms of your body is not working at the end of the day. If you want to obtain the same skill and be a powerful leader, I believe you always have to have something above yourself. You have to have a higher purpose. You have to believe in a higher energy. Why? Because number one, it humbles you. Second of all, it gives you purpose. Number three, it frees you from your ego, because ego means edging God out, which proves again that if you believe in a higher thing and a higher purpose, you will lead differently. When I came home and I saw my mom crying because of money, always at the end of the month, it kind of hurted me. I stood up, I'm against the system. Even if I work, I cannot even take care of myself. My mom's working three jobs. So I kind of started to have like an intrinsic hate against the system. I don't know if you ever had that, and I'm not hating the system and not giving you any conspiracy theories, but all of you know intrinsically that if you have a job, if you work hard, if you do all of this, most likely you will never achieve your goals. When we are young, we have the goals like driving a Ferrari, becoming a princess, like for all the girls, like everyone wants to become a princess. Everyone wants to become a president, right? All the men in here. And when you're 18, you are the perfect slave after going through the educational system and you lost your dreams. You basically get paid just to survive, because job at the end, J-O-B, means just over broke. My mentor told me that back then, if you have a job, you're just over broke. Everyone that I know is just over broke. Even if you make a lot of money, most likely you don't have a lot of money because you are not educated. You were never educated, and you will never be educated if you don't educate yourself about and around money.
If you are someone that talks too much and shares too much information, remember, loose lips sink ships. Don't overshare, especially if you have big goals. Most people will be uncomfortable when you share your goals, especially if they are big goals. So one thing of becoming an entrepreneur that is really important is don't overshare. Keep the stuff for yourself. Don't tell people your next moves, because that's how you're going to be more successful in your business and in your future. And you cut out negativity and egos from other people, and you can easily focus on your goals without having distraction from other people. If you would have shared it, you would have get negativity. So again, loose lips sink ships.
What
What I'm trying to say, the point that I'm trying to make is like, if you are young and that's what you watch, how high is the probability that you will adopt the same thinking by just watching it? Because every movie, every series, and it starts with kids. It's not like it's movies for adults, but most movies, most media teaches you that if you have money, you have a bad life. You're miserable, right? You are a bad person, right? So that's crazy for me. If you really think about it, how crazy is that? Money is, at the end of the day, what you make with it, right? Money is just, it's just energy, it's just a tool. But I figured out that with money you have less headache, with money you have opportunities, you can see the world, you can travel, you can impact, right? The stuff that you do to yourself with money, the stuff that you can afford with money is nice. It's nice treating yourself nicely. But you know what is more beautiful? What I found out for myself is giving it back to people that you love. There are four ways to make money. Someone heard about Rich Dad Poor Dad. He said there's four ways to make money. You can be employed, you can be self-employed, you can be an entrepreneur, someone that builds a system that has other people working for them, and you can be an investor, okay? These are four ways to make money. Now on the left side, from you, the other side, right side, right, there's being employed, so trading time for money, and there is trading more hours for more money, right? So someone that is self-employed, someone that has their own grocery shop, they work a lot of hours, but they make more money. Now on the right side, we have people that have systems, entrepreneurs, and then we have people that invest money. Did you know that 95% of the people are employed and self-employed, right? Most people are employed, 95%. 5% are entrepreneurs and investors. Now, when it comes to the money, and that's the only thing you have to understand today, because when I understood this, it changed my life. It is that 95% of people only have 5% of the whole wealth, and 5% of the people have 95% of all the money, of all the wealth. That's not how wealth and money works anymore. It was back then, right? Back then, it's like you get a job, you have a safe job, you work 45 years, you get, you know, money from the system, you get retirement money, you have a nice house, you have a nice car. One man could provide for his whole family. Do you see any family out there where one man, and excuse me, like it's not against the women, but where one man can basically provide for his whole family, or even one woman could provide for the whole family? It's not possible. Everyone that I know, both of them work, man and woman. So the whole system works. So you cannot take the old ways on how to make money. You will need to learn new ways. And the new way is network marketing. The new way is trading. The new way is cryptocurrencies. The new way is what we do. And if you are sitting here right now, please don't take it too serious, but I'm very direct in what I say, and you think this is a scam, it just shows me how uneducated you are when it comes to new terms and new business ideas, because that's how the world works. Like all the media, everything, the whole society tells you every day that you are a piece of shit. Now, if the whole society, the whole media, your parents, everyone around you that tells you that you are a piece of shit, what do you expect of your life? Nothing. You have to break out of this vicious circle. You have to break out and understand that you are the most powerful thing in this world. And even if it's not, I don't care. I rather believe that I'm very powerful than sit there and think, oh, I'm just a human. I just have 80 years. Let's bring it over. Let's just live. And it's not about how long you live. It's about the quality that you live. All our parents, the whole society is always based on, oh, I want to become 80. I want to become 100. It's all about how long I live. No, it's not how long you live. I could die today and I know I had a beautiful life and I did everything I wanted to do. There's so much more I want to do, and I'm grateful for every other day, but it's the quality of life that you live, not the quantity of life. We all have this perception and concept that we have like time. Sometimes you say when older people die, you say, oh, it's so early that they die, 50, 52, 53. It's too early. Bro, you never know when it's early. You never know. So three reasons why people don't have a lot of money, or why people don't want to make a lot of money, or why people maybe think they are not made for this lifestyle. It's either they have an ego, lazy, or ignorant, right? Many people have egos. They're like, oh, why should I listen to him? Like, I'm studying. And that's good that you're studying. Again, I'm not here to hate on anyone, right? If you are happy, I'm happy, right? I don't care. But most people are just egos when it comes to opportunities. They're like, oh no, that's like one of these things, right? It's always the same, scamming people, all that shit, right? It's always the same.
When I joined this business for the first time, many people started to talk about in these trainings, like we do these trainings about the power of the mindset, that what you believe in is what turns into reality. What you hold in your mind, you will hold in your hands, that you have to focus on it, that you have to think about it, that everything is the power of the mind. And I was kind of like, I was not against it, but I was also like, bro, like if it's that easy, if I only think positive and my life changes, then let's get it, right? So I started to read the book, The Secret. It's an unbelievable book. Basically, my life started to change because of that. Because for the first time in my life, I understood the sense of the universe. I understood that I can impact my life. What you don't understand is that you are the person that dictates your life, your thoughts, not you, but your thoughts. So everything, every position, I know it's very hard to say that. And I know in fact that this is true, that every position, every situation that you are in your current life is because you chose it.
you are the most powerful, the most beautiful, the most craziest, the best that exists out there. It's facts. You know what I mean? And I'm sorry for saying that, but some of us have to tell you that you are so powerful and that you are beautiful and you are perfect as you are. And if you are imperfect, then work on it every day. You know what I mean? Work on it every day, because that's the most beautiful thing about this business, is personal development. The business will personally develop you to someone, to a superhuman. It's facts. You know what I mean? It's crazy. And for me, the thing that I hate about the world is that people like you, you really think that you cannot achieve anything, that you are not meant to achieve anything, that you are meant to stay stuck in a job to do the bullshit over and over again. It's true. And that this is my mission. And you see, I'm not talking about money. I'm not talking about trading. I'm not talking about the products, because first you have to get this right.
I have a very controversial take on this, but taking advantage of crisis makes you not a bad person, but an early person. If you see something happening in this world, you need to understand that there will be people that make money out of that. So don't feel emotions. Don't be someone that says, oh, I don't want to do it because of moral and ethics. I mean, it's very important that you have moral and ethics, but taking advantage of a crisis doesn't make you stupid, doesn't make you a bad person. It just makes you early, because people are going to do it anyways. Example, Russian ruble fall, crypto fall, the general finance market when COVID had fallen, you could have bought. Any other catastrophes and what happens will always have an effect on the financial markets. So be early and make money.
Top G! Free Top G!
Free Top G!
Free Top G! Free Top G!